To begin at the beginning. It is spring. Moonless night in the small town, starless and Bible black. The cobble streets silent, and the hunched quarters and rabbits wood limping invisibly down to the slow black, crow black fishing boat bobbing sea. These are the opening lines of Dylan Thomas's most famous work, Under Milk Wood. He wrote them here in Larne, South Wales. He wrote them about Larne, nestling on the banks of the tidal estuary of the River Taff, beneath the romantic ruins of a medieval castle. He described Larne as timeless, a mild, beguiling island of a town, the strangest town in Wales. A bus trip to Larne from his hometown of Swansea marked a turning point in Dylan's life. In his own words, "I just came to Larne one day, for the day, and never left. Got off the bus and forgot to get on again." In fact, he first came to Larne to entice his future wife Caitlin away from her lover, the artist Augustus John. On later visits, he was scrounging accommodation for his family. He eventually spent his final years here in the boathouse at Larne, which was bought for him by his friend Margaret Taylor, although with less enthusiasm by her husband, the historian A.J.P. Taylor. Dylan was a seriously flawed character. He was a sensitive, emotional, romantic poet. He could be very witty and charming, and the life and soul of any party. But he was also totally irresponsible, lazy, selfish, unfaithful to his wife, a drunkard, forever in debt, with a vicious and obscene tongue. It's surprising that he kept any friends at all. On the cliff path to the boathouse is a small shed, in which Dylan wrote his most famous works. He could gaze through the window and watch the ever-changing moods of the estuary below and the wooded hills beyond. He could have romantic thoughts about the little town and its shattered castle. He could recall the local gossip in his favourite bar in the Browns Hotel, or at least as much as he could remember through the drunken haze of the night before. He could create the timeless Welsh characters of Under Milk Wood. He could watch and listen as he wrote, "Time passes, listen. Time passes. You can hear the dew falling and the hushed town breathing." He was offered a series of extremely lucrative lecture tours in America, any one of which could have cleared all his debts. But unfortunately, he always drank the income before he got home. Before he left for the third and last American tour, he sent the BBC his final draft of Under Milk Wood as a radio play. He arrived in New York on October the 20th, 1953. 2 weeks later, he staggered into the Chelsea Hotel and collapsed in a coma, saying, "18 straight whiskies. I think that's a record." Dylan died at the age of 39. Although there is a memorial to him in Westminster Abbey, his body was brought back to his beloved Larne, where it lies beneath a simple white wooden cross. How should we remember Dylan Thomas? As the wild boy of Wales, or as a great romantic poet? He never caught that last bus from Larne, and now lies forever under Milk Wood.